to Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More prayer breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More Prayer Breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More Prayer Breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More Prayer Breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor women the way Christ honors his bride, the church. May God continue to bless you. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. To Carolyn White Washington, Sisters for Sisters Incorporated, and to all who are attending the Silent Tears No More Prayer Breakfast, thank you so very much for blessing me and humbling me with the Love Cares Award. Please know that I would much prefer to be there in person with you to meet those of you who are on a day-to-day basis committed to this critical work which impacts the very fabric of our community. Inasmuch as the proceeds from this prayer breakfast will help fund programs which provide direct access and resources to women and families escaping abuse, it's really more appropriate that I commend the collective expression of love shown by all of you. You know, I shared with Carolyn that I worked for 2 years with the Verizon Foundation and its Domestic Violence Awareness and Prevention Program, spending a day at the Domestic Violence Hotline Center in Austin, Texas, talking with and interviewing numerous domestic violence survivors and their family members, moderating a number of workshops in National Football League cities with the co-founders of A Call to Men and more. It was an enlightening and indeed a sobering experience. Now, I know that men and women are victims, but the overwhelming majority of the abused are women. So we men, therefore, need to be the overwhelming majority involved in solving this crisis. How a man treats a woman is reflective of what he thinks about himself. And for those of us who call ourselves Christians, we need to honor